It was 1974, and the most powerful man of oldest democracy in the world had to resign.
Therefore, I shall resign.
It was none other than the then President of United States, Richard Nixon. And the reason was Watergate scandal. It was revealed that Nixon was involved in wiretapping phones and stealing documents. This scandal was unearthed by two journalists of the Washington Post, Bob Woodward and Carl Bernstein. These two men are basically those who actually exposed and restarted something which was long lost: investigative journalism. Hello, a very warm welcome to you from SGT University. I am Aditi Agarwal from Faculty of Mass Communication. Today we will be learning about investigative journalism. Investigative journalism is a type of journalism that requires in-depth research into a specific topic. Oftentimes, these topics are about corruption, crime, financial crime, or other abuses that may go unnoticed for several years. The exposing of Watergate scandal in US is one of the biggest examples of investigative journalism in the world. The Watergate scandal was a political scandal that began early in the morning of June 17, 1972, when several burglars were arrested in the office of the Democratic National Committee located in the Watergate complex of buildings in Washington, D.C. This was no ordinary robbery. The prowlers were connected to President Richard Nixon's re-election campaign, and they had been caught wiretapping phones and stealing documents. Nixon took aggressive steps to cover up the crime, but when Washington Post reporters Bob Woodward and Carl Bernstein revealed his role in the conspiracy, Nixon resigned on August 9, 1974. The Watergate scandal changed American politics forever, leading many Americans to question their leaders and think more critically about the presidency. In India also, there are many examples of investigative reporting that led to uncovering of major scams. Let's discuss some of them. The Hindu's Bofors Expose. The Bofors scam was one of the biggest political scandals that happened between India and Sweden in 1980s and 1990s. It majorly involved top politicians from the ruling party, primarily implicating the then Prime Minister and several people from the Swedish government. These people were accused of receiving kickbacks from a bank called Bofors AB. It was done to win a bid to supply India's 155mm field howitzer, a shotgun for firing shells on high trajectories at low velocities. The scandal was uncovered mostly by the Chennai-headquartered The Hindu and reported by Chitra Subramaniam and N. Ram. Almost 200 documents relating to Bofors were secretly sourced, verified and translated from the Swedish language before being published, along with interviews and analytical pieces. Such was the public fury stoked by this investigation that the government in power eventually ending up on the losing side in the 1989 general election. 2G scam. The massive Indian telecom scandal in 2011 was preceded only by Watergate in Time magazine's top 10 abuses of power. At the center of this scam was an allegation that the then telecom minister undercharged mobile companies for frequency allocation licenses and even accepted bribes. The expose that cost Indian government ₹1,76,000 crore was spearheaded by pioneer reporter J. Gopikrishnan, who followed the story for many years. So these were some of the prominent examples where investigative reporters uncovered major scams. Had reporters not uncovered these scams, we would have never known about them. So this is the power of investigative journalism. Reporters who dig deep to discover the truth are called investigative reporters. They suspect that there is often more than what meets the eye. Unlike conventional reporting, where reporters rely on materials supplied by the government, NGOs and other agencies, investigative reporting depends on material gathered through the reporter's own initiative. Investigative reporting has following features. It is about digging deeply into an issue or topic. The issue or topic has to be of public interest. Investigative reporting is a process and not just an event. It should produce new information or put together previously available information in a new way to reveal its significance. The practice aims at exposing public matters that are otherwise concealed, either deliberately or accidentally. Investigative journalism is not instantaneous. It develops through recognized stages of planning, researching, and reporting, and has to adhere to accepted standards of accuracy and evidence. Now let's discuss some of the qualities that you need to have to become a successful investigative reporter. Courage. You might need to investigate and report against top politicians, bureaucrats, and other influential people. Reporting against influential people could be risky, so you really need courage for that. Passion. If you enjoy challenges and want to serve your readership or audience with stories that matter, no matter how much time and energy it costs you, and even if some powerful people will end up with maybe less than friendly feelings towards you, then by all means go for it. Logical thinking, organization, and self-discipline. Investigative reporting takes time, and because of the legal risks it often carries, fine-grained verification. So you need to become a careful planner to make the best use of your time. Be obsessive about checking and rechecking facts and make sure the story fits together. Broad general knowledge and good research skills. Understanding the context of the investigation can help avoid dead ends by identifying relevant facts and questions. However, if the investigation leads into an unfamiliar area, investigative journalists must be able to familiarize themselves with the background, conventions, terminology, role players, and issues of that area quickly. The ability to have an informative conversation with an expert, use search engines, or locate and skim read useful books are all vital here. Now, after learning about investigative journalism, you might ask, are investigative reporters detective? Well, if referring to the skills detectives employ, the answer is yes, investigative reporters are detective. But the difference lies in purpose. The purpose of investigative reporting is only and only public interest. The journalist researches the question to formulate a hypothesis about its answer and social meaning. He or she then does more research, following paper trails, conducting interviews that may sometimes feel more like interrogations, and putting together a mass of evidence, some of which is extremely detailed or technical. So today we covered investigative journalism. The next time we meet, we will be discussing about sting operation. Keep learning, keep growing. See you next time.